and welcome to our Holden team online Christmas service. And it's great to be sharing this ministry with Reverend Jane Frost and Reverend Sue Astbury. And you'll see them when they speak. So yes, we're recording this from our homes to be with you in your homes so that you feel included in the community over Christmas. Because of course we are all linked by one spirit that joins us, and a spirit of joy and peace at Christmas. So you are very welcome to be with us. Let us pray. Sweet child of Bethlehem, grant that we may share with all our hearts in this profound mystery of Christmas. Pour into the hearts of people of peace, which they sometimes seek so desperately, and which you alone can give. Help all to know one another better and to live as brothers and sisters, children of the same Heavenly Father. Awaken in all people's hearts love and gratitude for your infinite goodness. Join them together in your love and give us your heavenly peace. Amen. God of love, open the hearts and minds of many this Christmas time to the good and saving news of Jesus Christ, that those whose lives are insecure or empty or aimless may find in the one born at Bethlehem all that they need today and much more besides, for his name's sake. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory. The glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Oh,
angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favoured one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there will be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." Now, the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband, Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken out while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Say that you're my God, you're all too.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours."
The angels had left them and gone into heaven. The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
God of love, open the hearts and minds of many this Christmas time to the good and saving news of Jesus Christ, that those whose lives are insecure or empty or aimless may find in the one born at Bethlehem all that they need today and much more besides. Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
O God, the Son, highest and holiest, who did humble thyself to share our birth and our death, bring us with the shepherds and wise men to kneel before your lowly cradle, that we may come to sing with thine angels, thy glorious praises in heaven, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit thou livest and reignest, God, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
And let's say the prayer which Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
May the joy of the angels and the eagerness of the shepherds,
the perseverance of the wise men and the obedience of Joseph and Mary.
And the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those you love this day and forevermore. Amen.
Good King Wenceslas last looked out on the feast of Stephen, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even. Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel, when a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel. Hither, page, and stand by me, if thou know'st it telling. Yonder peasant, who is he? Where and what his dwelling? Sir, he lives a goodly hence, underneath the mountain, right against the forest fence, by St. Agnes Fountain. Bring me mead and bring me wine, bring me pine logs hither. Thou and I will see him dine, when we bear him thither. Page and monarch, forth they went together, through the rude wind's wild lament, and the bitter weather. Sire, the night grows darker now, and the wind blows stronger. Fails my heart, I know not how, I can go no longer. Mark my footsteps, good my page, tread them in them boldly. Thou shalt feel the winter's rage, freeze thy blood less coldly. In his master's steps he trod, where the slow lay dinted. It was in the very sod which the saint had printed. Therefore, Christian men, be sure, wealth or rank possessing, ye who now will bless the poor, shall yourselves find blessing.